It is 11:10 and the meeting will return to order. The chair has been requested by the interpreters to slow down just a little bit between taking the affirmative and negative votes to allow them to keep caught up. And the chair apologizes to the interpreters for running on so fast. The next item on page 10 of the printed agenda is the 5% solution. Item B1-2. Moved to amend the WSFS Constitution to eliminate the requirement that finalists must appear on at least 5% of ballots in a category by striking out words as follows. It would strike out all of section 3.8.5 and sections of 3.11.4. The chair recognizes, the debate time on this is 6 minutes. Yes, 6 minutes. The chair recognizes, if he's here, the maker of the motion, Mr. Garib. Desjardins. The chair recognizes Mr. Desjardins.
My name is Stephen Desjardins. It's spelled lowercase D-E-S, no space, capital J-A-R-D-I-N-S. The intent of the 5% rule was to stop works with negligible support from getting on the ballot when there were very few works with substantial support. However, now that there's been a renaissance of short fiction, there are literally dozens of Hugo-worthy works being published in many different venues, and it's becoming more and more difficult for any one of them to cross the 5% threshold, because not everyone reads the same works. Not everyone even reads the same recommended reading lists. And Hugo voters, in general, have a laudable reluctance to coordinate their nominations. So we have a paradoxical system that's responding to an increase in the number of Hugo-worthy works by reducing the number of slots they get on the final ballot. The 5% rule, it was well-intentioned, it's had a good run, we've seen how it works, and we found that it makes more problems than it solved. It's time to abolish it.
A speech against adoption, Mr. Yellow.
Still Ben Yellow. I'd like to provide somewhat of a correction to what was stated as the intent of the rule, being the maker of the initial motion for the 5% rule. The feeling was not that there wasn't a great deal of worthy work. The feeling was that if you couldn't make 5% of the ballots, what you're looking at is noise, not signal. Square root of n is not your friend when you're looking at a tiny number of ballots. And what that means is that the work that is in fifth place and the work that is in sixth place and the work that is in fourth place are effectively all getting the same number of votes, and therefore let's throw out the long tail. It is possible that that is no longer meaningful, but the purpose is not to eliminate works, it's to try and separate signal from noise.
A speech in favor, yes.
Still Joshua Kronengold. Before I was a Neo, the year I shan't debate, we made a rule for our premier award. Even if it made the cut, a nomination met its fate. If 1 in 20 didn't think it scored. At first it seemed a good rule, avoided the long tails. But later when the field ballooned in size, if our population fails to all read the same tales, where the ballot's concerned there's too much for the prize, then yes, the genre was small. Now, though, you can't read it all. Then tastes were more concentrated, the best stories rated, for the Hugos were slated. We must this rule amend. At this point, it's hard to defend. I think that it makes no sense to drop works that lack 5%. Thank you.
In favor. The chair...
Can I get a copy of those lyrics, please?
The chair, yes. However, the chair classifies the member's previous speech as a funny once, and the members are advised to take that as it may. A speech against the adoption? You have an amendment. That would be okay. Dr. Lurie?
Given our earlier discussion about whether or not Hugo administrators could publish the results of candidates receiving fewer than 4-5 votes, I would move to amend the proposal to strike out, but not including any candidate receiving fewer than 5 votes.
In the second half of the amendment, section 3.11.4, the last few words of the existing 3.11.4 are, but not including any candidate receiving, is that what you were asking?
Yes. So
yeah, the last few words, all the rest of the sentence, correct?
Right. What it says is that the Hugo committee shall make public within 90 days after the Worldcon the nominating voting totals in each category for the top 15 vote getters, but not including any candidate receiving fewer than 5 works. I would just strike the but not including any candidate receiving fewer than 5 works.
The chair rules the amendment not germane to the subject of the original amendment. The original amendment is on taking up the issues of 5%. This exceeds the scope of the original proposal and is primarily in there to show the context. You can introduce it next year as a new idea if you wish. All right. We're looking then for a speech against the proposal. Any speech? All right. Mr. Jardin is appealing the ruling of the chair that the amendment to strike out the last few words of 3.11.4 is not germane. Is there a second to the appeal?
Second.
Very well. How much time total remains in debate?
134 seconds.
Let's make that 130 seconds divided in half. Okay. That will.
Divided in half, you mean split equally between the times, not half of that for the discussion on the appeal?
No. The appeal in favor of the chair and opposed to the chair, half and half of that 130
okay.
seconds.
That's what it'll be anyway.
The chair believes that, and this is not the first time this has happened, we show the context of amendments, but the actual scope of the amendment proposed to the body was to deal with the 5% rule. We are going afield from that, further afield than we need to in a proposal. It is a different subject entirely to deal with the fewer than 5 votes in this case. And that's the chair's ruling on that. A speech against the ruling of the chair, Dr. Lurie.
While I agree somewhat with what the chair has just said, it seems to me that if you eliminate the 5% rule, you are far more likely to see candidates that receive fewer than 5 votes in the top 15 nominees. And therefore, I think it is relevant because it is a direct result of the effect of the other part of the proposal.
Speech in favor of the ruling of the chair. I'm trying to think who hasn't had an opportunity. Well, Mr. Yallo was the first one who stood up. Mr. Yallo.
In any question of germaneness. In any question of germaneness, it has to be germane to what the initial motion is doing. The initial motion is only touching the 5% rule, and anything outside the 5% rule would not therefore be germane.
Okay, a speech. Question of privilege. The member will come to the microphone, state your name, state the question.
My name is Terry Neal, and my point of privilege is that there are several people in this room who cannot pop to their feet as fast as Mr. Yallo. And I would request that you take that into consideration when you are choosing who to speak. Thank you.
The chair will attempt to bear that in mind. Speech against the chair, Mr. Deterjean.
There was a ruling the other day that this was a minimum, that this was intended to be, but not including any candidate receiving fewer than five votes. It was not intended to be a restriction, that this was a minimum that they were required to publish, not a maximum. And I'm afraid that by deleting the text, it will change the interpretation. And so it was not our intent to change that interpretation of
Time for debate opposing the chair's ruling has expired. How much time remains in favor?
15 seconds.
The chair would like to use the rest of it. Okay. The question of germaneness is a matter of scope. It would be no more the chair believes it would be no more in scope to strike the last few words of it than to go ahead and to strike out 90 and insert 180. On the question of the germaneness of this motion, those who believe the chair's ruling is correct and that the amendment to strike the last few words of 311.4 is not germane and therefore not in order, those who believe the chair's ruling is correct, raise your hands. Hands down. Those opposing the chair's ruling, hands down. There being less than the majority in the negative, the chair's ruling is sustained. The amendment is not germane. Debate, I do believe that all debate for this proposal has expired. Is there a motion to extend debate? I'm asking Mr. Kernengold, who's rose.
No, I wish you had a motion to amend. You can't.
Yes, in fact, he can make a motion to amend. It would be undebatable. Mr. Kernengold, come to the microphone to state your amendment.
I move to amend modifying 3.11.4. Inserting the word non-finalist before candidate in, but not including any candidate before receiving fewer than five votes. So it would now read, but not including any non-finalist candidate receiving fewer than five votes.
The chair also rules the amendment not germane. Does anyone want to try to appeal that? It's an undebatable appeal. All those in favor of the chair's ruling that the amendment is not germane, raise your hands. Hands down. Those opposed, raise your hands. Hands down. The chair's ruling is sustained. The amendment is not germane. Mr. Glazer.
I would like to move to extend debate by 2 minutes.
That would be 1 minute each side, correct?
Correct.
Is there a second? What is the question? Come to the speaker. I restated the short amendment, but what's the question of privilege?
My name is Terry Neal, and you are still talking too fast for the translators.
I'll try. It has been moved and seconded to extend the debate by 2 minutes, which of course would be evenly divided. A two-thirds vote being necessary to extend debate. All those in favor of extending the day, raise your hands. Hands down. Those opposed, there being less than 10 hands down, debate is not extended. The question is, The question is on the adoption of B.1.2, the 5% solution, as printed. A majority being necessary to adopt this and send it on to next year's Worldcon. All those in favor, raise your hands. Hands down. Those opposed, hands down. The affirmative has it. The motion is adopted and is sent on to next year's Worldcon for ratification. Next is, B15, multiple nominations. Question of privilege, member will state their question of privilege.
My name is Kate Secor, and I was wondering if it would be possible.
Microphone, thank you.
I was wondering if it would be possible to add the page numbers on the slides next to the things that are up for debate.
The answer is yes.
The answer is yes. The parliamentarian will do what they can. The head table is getting caught up. Where'd it go? It's next is multiple nominations, item B.B.15. Oh, I see what happened. It starts on page 22. That's what threw me off. All right. Are you ready? Item B.15, multiple nominations. Moved to amend the WSFS Constitution to eliminate the possibility of a work simultaneously appearing on the final ballot in multiple categories by adding words as follows. Insert the following section after section B, I'm sorry, after section 3-8. No work shall appear in more than one category on the final award ballot. 2. Insert the following section after existing section 3-8-6. If a work is eligible in more than one category, and if the work receives sufficient nominations to appear in more than one category, the Worldcon committee shall determine in which category the work shall appear after consulting with the author of the work, insofar as it is possible to do so under the provisions of section 3.9. Which of the makers of this motion wants preference in speaking? The chair recognizes Mr. Dashoff. The younger, yes. Sorry. This has 6 minutes debate time.
Jared Dashoff, or Mr. I guess I'm the younger, sure.
Hold the mic.
Swallow.
Hold it. Yeah, there you go.
I'm too tall for this mic stand. We proposed this amendment mostly out of the other motion that we have proposed, which is the best series, but it has some applicability elsewhere, and it is mostly concerned with making sure that in the potential world where there is a best series, that a book which is eligible in both series and novel cannot be in both. And it would also apply to a potential YA Hugo should one become into existence. And I would like to note that this is generally done in other categories where the Hugo administrator moves things based on the creator of the work.
For what the member wants, will the member yield for a question?
Yes.
Remember it's using up your debate time.
My name is Kate Secor, and I would like to ask, if a work of original fiction is published on a podcast, and that podcast is then nominated in Best Fancast, does that prevent the story from appearing in the story categories as a subset of the podcast that was nominated?
As a not Hugo administrator, because I'm not insane, I don't know if I can answer that. My gut reaction would be no, the work of original fiction is a different work from the podcast because they are different categories rather than two written fiction works, like a YA work and a novel work. But I can't speak to that definitively. That would be a better question for someone who has been a past or future Hugo administrator.
An excellent answer.
Speech against. Have you relinquished the floor, Mr. Dashoff? Yeah, in that case, it's too late. Yeah, that's right. Speech against. Mr. Lorenz.
My name is John Lorenz. As Mr. Dad.